the brutal rape and murder of a 31-year-old doctor in Kolkata's RG Carr Hospital has shook the conscience of the nation. It has once again started the debate on women's safety and security. And not just that, it has actually started a much more specific debate on the protection of our healthcare workers. To show solidarity and seek justice for the deceased, multiple protests are being held for the last few days in multiple parts of the country, and Mumbai is one of them. Right now we are in Mumbai's Azad Maidan area, and you can see a group of citizens. These are not just doctors, these are people from every walk of life, and they are here to seek justice for the daughter of the nation. They are here to seek justice for, as I said, you can see that there are women participants as well. They are here to seek justice for themselves, to seek safety. There are men here seeking justice for their daughters, their sisters, their wives. We'll speak to some of them and, you know, understand what exactly it made them feel the moment they heard this news. Ma'am, the moment you heard of this news, what was your first reaction? What was the first thought which came to your mind?
I was very outraged, yes, and angry, and also shocked. Not because this was a very heinous crime, but that this kind of gruesome and heinous crime is happening across India. Just now you must have heard a 13-year-old girl in Bihar also has been brutally murdered, and in a very, her body has been disfigured in a very bad way. A 13-year-old girl has been raped and abducted. It's happening in Hathras, it's happening in Uttarakhand, it's happening in Bihar, and now in Kolkata. So Kolkata was supposed to be a very safe place for the women, and now today you look at what has happened. So I was angry and shocked both.
Absolutely, and she had all the reasons, because if I talk about numbers, as per the NCRB report 2022, over 47,000 instances of crimes against women were recorded. It was an increase, because in 2021 the number was around 42,000, and in 2020, because of the pandemic, the number was slightly low, 30,000. But it's still extremely, extremely worrisome, because as per a 2018 report of NCRB, one woman is reported raped every 15 minutes. That is the kind of number we are looking at, sir. One woman raped every 15 minutes. We are talking
very, very scary situation where we can't even protect the laws or the nexus between the political and the public, and the police and other thing have suppressed this feeling. So we need, not as a doctor but also as a community, that unless this is there, there is no democracy.
Absolutely. We have failed our daughters once again, and this time it was a daughter who was out there serving the people. She was a health worker, she was a doctor, she finished a 36-hour long shift, and she was just looking for a safe place to rest. As I said, this gruesome instance has also started a debate about safety of health workers. The situation is extremely worrisome in our country. I'm being joined by a group of doctors. Dr. Shweta, I'd like to start with you. In 2018, government did show an intention of passing a central bill seeking ensuring security and safety and action against those who were attacking health workers. That draft did not go anywhere. And right now, the doctors are demanding a central healthcare protection law. What exactly are you seeking under this particular, you know, if it ever comes into existence?
I mean, it's imperative that doctors who care for our patients, who care for our sickest and most vulnerable, need to feel safe. I don't think as doctors we can provide the quality of care that we desire for our patients if we are living in fear. But this is not just about doctors, as this march is really about women's safety in the workplace. It is wonderful to have legislation passed. It's a commitment from a government which we absolutely seek. But it's also about everybody's responsibility in the workplace. In order to enact such a bill, we also need everybody at the work to believe that and to actually embody this safe working practices for our women across all industries.
Absolutely. So Dr. Shweta actually worked at the KEM hospital. Right now she practices in London, but the reason I'm mentioning KEM hospital, because in 1973 another healthcare worker, Aruna Shanbhag, a nurse, was sexually assaulted, and that left her into a vegetative state for years. It was only in 2015 that you know, we got the news of her death. So not the first instance of, and since you were at KEM, so if you can, you know, I'm sure.
As medical students and residents at KEM Hospital, we knew this legacy, we lived this legacy, we saw it. And yet here, 25 years after I've graduated, we're still seeing this horrendous situation for our young doctors across the country. It's absolutely unacceptable. In the 21st century, in India that's, you know, shining, we cannot be shining in the world if we cannot look after our women and we cannot make sure that there's safe, safe working practices for our healthcare workers.
Absolutely. So, ma'am, in 2009, Bombay High Court instructed the state government to ensure proper CCTV camera installation and security guards allotment deployment at all the medical colleges and hospitals. As per an RTI, which was filed last year, 40% of those cameras are not working, either not installed or not working. So, you know, what hope do the citizens have? Because court has instructed, you know, some multiple protests have taken place. So where do you see this leading to? What do you see, where, according to you, what should be the next step? Where do you think this is leading to?
So I think the one thing we need to highlight out here, that while it was a doctor who had this problem, the high point of the takeaway, this is for women. Whether it's a doctor or it's a lawyer's office or it's a BMC office for that matter or the railway station, women itself are at risk almost all the time. I think we are just taught to look out and keep our eyes open to look around and see what's happening so that we don't get compromised in any way. That needs to stop. The CCTV needs to be for women. The CCTV needs to be to see that we feel safe. It's a sham most of the time. But the concept should be that women should feel safe when they walk out and they are safe in any workspace, wherever they may be in the world.
Which they clearly are not, and that's exactly why these people have gathered here. And as you can see, they have formed a circle. They are here to show solidarity. They are here to seek justice. And as I said, one, according to an NCRB report, and this is a 2018 data, one woman is raped every 15 minutes. This is what we are looking at. These are just the cases which get reported. Ma'am, this was something which happened at a workplace. It is not a secret that women are not even safe in their homes. But workplace till now, at least to some extent, it was considered safe because of the CCTV installation, because of some security guards. But it has opened a Pandora box. And if you can share your experience, how safe do you feel when you step out to work, when you are in your home, when you are in the streets? What is your experience as a woman?
So I've worked for almost over 35 years now, and it's never been easy for women. I mean, I'm sure you know that as well. But this particular incident is absolutely appalling because it happened in a hospital. So some places were considered as sacred. You know, those kind of things didn't happen there. They may happen on a road, in a sort of a public, but a quiet place. But things didn't happen in places like hospitals. So I think that it's really important that we as women stand up and reclaim the night.
Absolutely.
And seek justice for this girl, because that there is a cover-up is most obvious. We just want the perpetrators to be caught and given justice.
Right. So, I'm specifically asking you this question because you're a man, and all these days on social media, women are not even allowed to, you know, vent properly. Because the moment they are venting, obviously there is a counter, I don't even want to call it an argument. There are people commenting on her clothes, her pictures, her work profile, all of this. What one advice would you want to give to the men of the society to, you know, behave, show some decency?
Trolling is for cowards. If anyone is doing it,
thank you for saying that.
That's all it is there. You can't do anything. People will keep speaking any which way, whichever way they want to. But the fact is fact. Whatever's happened is absolutely disgusting, appalling. And I mean, not just for Smith, but all the other girls who go through this thing day in, day out, whether it is in a bus, whether it is in anything, it is enough. Stop it.
And this is again a very mundane question, but I still want to ask it. the way our authorities, the way our law and order system, the way our politicians look at crimes against women, do you think that now is the time that people actually start voting based on women's safety so that they can get some result out of it? Because otherwise it's just lip service.
Yeah, I think voting changes everything. Very shameful that
we don't vote.
We are still debating on it rather than acting on it. Yeah. What can we say? And unless we as a citizenry change, nothing is going to change. Government, police can use force, but as a conscience, we have to wake up. This won't change.
Yes, ma'am.
I would like to see three legislations come through. Hmm. One is that the penalty for rape should be levied at the highest level. There should be hanging per se for rape, without exception. All rape cases should be tried in a time-bound manner. The second thing is, even marital rape should be outlawed. Right now it isn't. And the third is that any juvenile committing a crime of as heinous as rape should be tried as a major, no matter what his age.
Not what happened during the Nirbhaya case.
In the case of the Nirbhaya, where he, and after that they did change the law, but it was only to 17. I'm saying even below. If you can commit a rape, you can be tried as a major. Those are my three points.
Absolutely. 21st century, and women of our country are still fighting for the most basic right to live with dignity, right to die with dignity, and to feel safe, whether it's at their homes or their offices. In Mumbai, with camera person Shailendra Kahar, this is Santhya for CNBC TV18.
Thank you for watching CNBC TV 18. For all top headlines and updates, follow us on our social media platforms.